Never knows how you'd come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well, I'm
all back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie. White on the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I would slap you.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Black as the ace of spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Thank you so much for being with me. Again, I hope you had a good weekend, folks. It is cold in L.A. When I came in this morning to the studio here, it was 34 degrees. Can you believe that? It was cold. It is colder than 90 going north. It's amazing. Be sure to visit my website, bondinfo.org, later today and take a look at the Sunday morning services. I think you're going to like it. It was some, if you didn't get a chance to be a part of it, you were not there yesterday, or you didn't watch it on the net anywhere in the world, bondinfo.org, bondinfo.org. All right, it'll be up later today. Talk about how the laws have changed. They're changing the laws on the books. And now the good folks have to deal with it in that the laws are against good and support evil. Whereas when I was growing up, it was the other way around. The laws protected the good from the evil. And we've allowed them to change most of the laws. We can't let this happen, folks. Go to bondinfo.org later today. All right? I'm taking your phone calls at 888-775-3773. 888-77-JESSE. Jam-packed show today. A lot of stuff going on. I'm looking at the clock here. And, 3 hours is not enough to deal with all this stuff, folks. There's no end to destruction. It just goes on and on and on and on and on in every area of our lives. That's why we have to overcome it with good. And then good will go on and on and on and on. Relationships are rough in America today. Over 50% of marriages end in divorce. There is a war on men. Many men are now saying that they are not going to even bother to get married because women are not women anymore. And, the roles have changed in relationships, so it's making it tough. I have with me the Lovers Rock and Anselm and Star Rock. writersforebony.com on love and relationships. They frequently write about their marriage and what they are learning along the way. And I want to talk to them about relationships. Good morning, guys. Welcome to the show.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you both for being with me. I absolutely appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
I read that you're celebrating today your 1-year wedding anniversary.
Yes, we are. Time flies.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
What has it been like this first year of marriage? What has that been like for you?
It's been interesting in a good way, a learning experience for the both of us. I think we're both able to kind of help each other modify certain things and also enhance certain things about ourselves. So on my end, it's definitely been great, and I hope Anselm can say the same.
What do you say, Anselm?
No, I definitely agree. It's been an amazing journey. We've been through so much in the past year.
Yes.
And I'm just glad that I've had a partner to go with the changes we've gone through this past year. So it's a constant growing, and learning.
Yes.
That's one thing you definitely have to see. It's work, it's learning, but it's been great. couldn't, you know, pick a better partner for this journey.
Aslam, are you the head of your wife?
No, she has her own head. She doesn't.
So
no, we like to think of ourselves as a partnership. We don't necessarily have like one designated head, because sometimes we feel like certain situations might cater to one strength. So the head can change depending on the situation.
Really?
That makes sense. Yeah.
So in most families or companies or businesses, there's a president and a vice president. And Aslam, if you're not the head of your wife, how do you correct her and guide her if you're not her? Let me ask first, are you guys Christians?
We're spiritual, but not religious, so not necessarily Christians.
Hey, how about you, Aslam?
Yeah, it's the same thing. We both have, you know, I went to Catholic school for 12 years. We have that foundation, but I think we both say we're not practicing, you know, at this point in time.
Oh, I see. So you guys don't believe in the principles of the Bible, in that God is the head of Christ, Christ is the head of man is the head of the woman. You don't believe that?
No, I wouldn't say that. I just say that the way that we run our household, it's that, you know, I don't look at Star as my employee. I'm not her boss. You know, I'm her husband.
Why do you think that that's what it means to be the head of your wife, that she's like an employee or, you know, something negative? Why do you see it that way?
Well, I think society sometimes puts it like that, you know, like where it can be taken to an extreme, and maybe I'm looking at the extreme of it. And I think, you know, just our philosophy, the way we, and people always kind of give us this kickback when we say that, oh, he's not the head of the household. But that's just how we look at it. We want to make sure it's an equal plane. I don't want to, you know, I'm older than her. I'm about 6 years older than her.
Good.
So I don't want to fall into, you know, a father role or anything like that. I want to make sure that everything is very even and equal. So I make a concerted effort to make sure that decisions are made together. You know, there are points, like she said, where I'll take charge and make a certain decision, but I still include her in it, and then she'll make decisions as well. So
what would happen if you made a decision and she didn't want to go along with it? Would you abandon your decision?
I think we would talk about it. You know, communication is key, you know, to our relationship or any relationship.
I know, but if she doesn't agree, and then I ask you the same thing, Star. If she doesn't agree with your decision, would you abandon your decision?
I think it depends on what the decision is revolving about. If something that really impacts her negatively, then I'll definitely consider changing my opinion. But if I'm an individual, she's an individual as well, and we each have our right to our own opinion on anything that we talk about, you know. So
is that a yes or no?
I can't give you a yes or no. It depends on what the situation is.
Yeah, because it's not that black and white for us. Like, it really does depend on the situation. I mean, that hasn't really happened.
Right.
But yeah, it's not really that black and white for us. I mean, of course, like, we relocated from New York City to Chicago, so that's a decision that, you know, neither one of us could really just make. So we of course had to talk to each other about that and weigh the pros and cons for both of us. But yeah, so it really does just depend on the situation.
And so, Star, if I'm understanding you right, if you made a decision about something that you really wanted to do, you felt it was the right thing, and Aslam disagreed with that decision, he would not, after talking about it, would you abandon your decision?
I mean, again, it really depends on what it is, because I don't see myself making a decision that would really make him upset. You know, I mean, we both have hobbies that we like to do individually, but outside of that, I don't really see anything happening. I mean, but we are, you know, newly married, so.
Right.
I don't know. It really depends on the situation.
So how do you feel it is the responsibility of the husband to guide his wife in the right way to go, to protect her spiritually and to guide her? How do you feel knowing that Aslam is incapable of doing that because he sees it as an equal partner?
I don't agree that he's incapable of doing that. Because, again, we're not coming from a Christian point of view, so I don't agree that he's incapable. Actually, I think he's a great leader, and he is capable of doing it, and he has done it for me quite a bit. There's a lot of things that he has helped me to see.
I know you write about your anger an article on Ebony.com, The Lovers Rock featured confessions of an angry black woman. So you are an angry black woman?
No, not at all. Well, one thing, the editor titled the article that, so uh-huh. I'm not an angry black woman. I'm not a stereotype, but I do sometimes have a hot temper. So that's what I'll say.
But a hot temper comes from anger.
Well, yeah, but I'm not an angry black woman the way you're trying to say it. And the way that, of course, the article is called that, but...
Yeah, I'm just calling it what the article is calling it.
Yes, the editor titled the article Angry Black Woman, but I am not an angry black woman.
Let me take a quick break. 888-775-3773. Welcome back, 888-775-3773. We're going to get to your phone calls here in a minute for my guest, Ann Slim and Star Rock. They are writers for Ebony.com, and they also do other things as well. Ann Slim is an editor, writer, relationship consultant, and a radio host as well. I want to get to some calls for you guys here. We were talking about anger, and Star, you said that you don't have anger, but you do, what happens to you at times?
No. What I said was,
you're not an angry
black woman, the way it's being framed, like to go with the stereotype. Do I get frustrated easily? Yes. Do I get angry in situations where I shouldn't get angry in? Yes. But this is not me as a person. This is not something that's like every day it's an issue. The article is about how in certain situations I realize, okay, I could have handled that differently. And it's my husband who helps me realize certain things about myself.
When you say the stereotype about angry black women, what do you mean? I don't understand that.
You don't know what the stereotype about angry black women is?
No.
That black women are bitter and angry. It's black and white. That's what the stereotype is.
Oh, but that's not a stereotype. That's true about most black women.
It's true about, from your opinion, it's true about most black women, and that's a horrible thing for you to say.
No, most people, including black men, would tell you that most black
based
women
based on
are,
what? Based on a stereotype. Do you know what a stereotype is? A stereotype is a general statement that is applied to a general group of people, and it's not true. It's not true about most black women. There's a lot of negative things that can be said about most black women, about most black men.
Ann Slim, you agree with me that most black women are angry?
No, I won't agree with you on that.
Why not?
Because you can't make it. I don't know every black woman in the world. I can't make that statement. Again, as my wife said, it's a stereotype.
Have you ever met one that was not angry?
You sound ridiculous right now, and this is not what we...
No, you brought it up, Star, so I just... Hold on.
You brought it up because of the article, and I'm trying to explain to you based on your tone of voice what it's not. And this is not what we agreed to interview for. We're thinking this is going to be a positive thing, and you're not making this a positive situation.
But it is positive.
No, it's not.
The truth is positive.
This is not the truth because this is baseless. You don't have any facts.
Your anger
is
showing.
You're going on stereotypes.
Star, your anger is showing.
I'm not angry. I'm okay. Fine.
You upset my wife, and I'm noticing what you're doing. You're baiting her into a situation to make her feel what you define as an angry black woman.
But that's not true. You can't make a person feel something that they don't already have within themselves.
No, it's not my fault.
You're being very condescending right now. We do not appreciate this.
But I'm doing is ask some questions. You guys are getting upset at me.
No. Let me speak for a second.
Go ahead.
You're asking questions that will hit certain triggers. You're mislabeling my wife as an angry black woman when she tells you that she's not, and that the label that was put on that article was put on by our editors, and then there's a stereotype that you say you don't know about, but then yet at the same time you say that all black women are angry.
I didn't say all, I said most.
You're correct, you said most.
Right.
So then when you say that statement, it's clear that you do know of the stereotype.
But it's not a stereotype, it's the truth.
That's your opinion. I'll let you have your opinion.
Yeah, let's move on because I want to get to some calls for you guys as well. You said that you're not Christians, but you're spiritual. What do you mean by that?
Well, what we mean by that is again, like I said earlier, I went to Catholic school for 12 years. My grandfather, who, you know, unfortunately passed when I was 10, he taught Bible study in his basement, you know, so I have that foundation. Mm-hmm. But as I've grown up and gotten older, you know, I haven't been part of the church on a regular basis. So I have the foundation. There's still things that I believe and certain tenets that are part of my life, but I won't label myself as a Christian because I don't walk the path completely. And I believe my wife would say the exact same thing as well.
Oh, okay. In relationships, a lot of men complain, this is to both of you, that they allow their wives to get away with whatever she wants to do. But in many cases, the wife don't allow the men to do whatever they want to do. What do you say to wimpy men who would cave into, and this is for both of you, to their wives in that manner?
Every relationship is different. Everyone has their own way of interacting with their partner. The quote-unquote wimpy men that you speak of, you know, I don't know if just because you allow your wife to have decisions or have a say in the relationship that defines you as wimpy. If your character as a general person is wimpy and everyone walks over you, then that's a different situation. But in terms of having a partnership in a relationship, I think that's how a relationship should work. There should be a partnership. There's sometimes that one person, quote-unquote, wins, and other times another person wins. It's really about who's really right in the situation, you know, so that's how we operate as a family and as a unit.
And then it depends on what you mean of what we're trying to get away with. That doesn't really sound positive.
I'm sorry, Star, we have some static there in your phone. Repeat what you just said.
And then it depends on what types of things you're speaking of about these men letting their women get away with. That doesn't really sound like.
But they don't let the women just get away with whatever they want to do. But if it's a man, the husband, he tend to go along. He tends to drop what he wants to do because he can't deal with his wife rejecting it. What would you say to a wimpy man like that?
I mean, don't be wimpy. If you don't like something, speak up on it.
Not to cave into her.
That goes for everybody. Anybody who doesn't have a backbone, if you don't like something, speak up about it.
But I've noticed, and I've noticed that in most relationships, not all, but most, the man become like a boy, child, and the husband become like a boy, like a child, and the wife becomes like his mother. He doesn't seem to know how to deal with her attitude. He's afraid to really speak up and disagree and be himself. How does one overcome that?
I can't speak on that. That's an individual thing. That's very. I haven't seen relationships like that. I have examples of marriages around me that I have not seen that. So I can't speak on that. I mean, if that is the case for that relationship, it doesn't sound healthy.
Let's go down to Memphis, Tennessee, and talk to. Let's talk to Black Conservative first. Black Conservative, welcome to the show.
Good morning, Jason. How are you?
All is well, sir. How about you?
I'm better than I deserve to be, being the most erudite mind, brilliant thinker, and political philosopher here. Listen, hello to your guest there. I'm listening here, you know, to what's going on here. Been listening for a while. You know, I sit there and pulled my hair out there. Just asked both of you all a direct question, and he didn't get a direct answer. You all filibustered him for about 2 minutes there. But yet you get upset.
Like you're doing right now to us.
Yeah.
Like he's doing right now to us.
Yeah. But y'all got upset at Jesse because he tried to, because he stated that the fact that an angry Black woman is a true statement. That's not a stereotype. That's a true fact.
You guys are funny. You guys are hilarious.
It's not funny. You know,
can I respectfully ask that you hurry up and get to your question, please?
I respectfully say this.
Let me take a quick break. We'll come back and get to that and more calls. 888-777-5773. Barack Hussein Obama and Big Mama Michelle. Back in a moment. Okay, folks, welcome back. We're going to get to as many calls here as possible. My guests are The Lovers Rock, Anslem and Star Rock, writers for Ebony.com on love and relationships, and we want to get these relationships to work. They're celebrating today their one-year wedding anniversary. Talking to them about an article for Ebony.com, The Lovers Rock features confessions of an angry black woman, what Mr. Rock patience is teaching me about my anger. Let's see here. Go back to the phones. Black conservative, did you have a question for my guest?
Yeah, I do have a question for your guest. I'm not going to go toe to toe with him today, but here's my question for them. He stated that they were spiritual. Yeah, my question is, you're all spiritual. My question is, what are you spiritual alive to? I mean, what have you become spiritual alive to? That's my question. I mean, are you saying to the things of God? What? If you say you're spiritual alive to what?
Well, for me, that's personal, but if Mr. Rock would like to answer, then he can feel free.
I'm not clear on what you mean by spiritual alive. Not familiar.
All right, okay, let me make it real simple, then I go.
Well, he's saying that you say you're not Christians, but you're spiritual.
Spiritual to what? Spiritual alive to what? Let me give you an example. For a Christian, we become spiritual alive to the things of God. We're made alive, born again, spiritual alive to the things of God. What have y'all become spiritual alive to? Because if you're not Christians, then you're not born again. You're not spiritual alive.
Let's get a response. Go ahead, sir. Okay.
I mean, yes, to the point, you know, like I said earlier, it's like I have a foundation. And as I've grown, you know, I've made my own decisions. I don't necessarily follow one specific religion's rules. So,
decisions. My question is, what are you spiritual alive to? You say, okay, first of all, we are born.
Let me do this because there are so many people who want to talk to my guest. I think that's the best answer they have for you.
Yeah, they don't have an answer.
You guys are hilarious and very insulting.
Star, before I go back to the phones, I'm getting truckloads of texts and emails here, and the men and the women are saying that on one hand, you're saying you're not angry, yet your anger is coming out.
It is coming out because, as we discussed, I was being baited to play that role. I am getting frustrated right now, and I will admit that, because this is not a fair playing field. And, of course, people who listen to your show and agree with you are going to feel that way because they're all coming from a standpoint of judgment. It's clear from when we first got on the phone with you that this is not what we were led to believe that this interview would be about. We're being judged for having different beliefs. You insulted my husband by saying he's not capable of leading me. And then when I tried to explain to you that the article that is titled Angry Black Woman, it actually has a positive spin on it because it's about the fact that in certain situations, he's teaching me that I can handle myself in a different way, in a better way. So I am coming across as angry because you're making generalizations. This is what you've done all day, and if you can't see
let me ask Star,
else to make you see that.
Star, I'm only asking you questions. It doesn't matter to me that you're an angry black woman or not, or that your husband...
This is exactly what you just did, and I'm sorry if your readers don't want to understand it. If you want to keep,
but let me ask you this, Star. Is it my fault that you have the anger, or did I put the anger there, or was already there?
This is the thing, sir. This is the
okay.
Thing.
Go ahead.
Today is our wedding anniversary. It's a very beautiful day for us. We're celebrating our 1 year of our marriage, 365 days.
Congratulations.
When we're looking to have a very beautiful day, we took time out of our anniversary to do this interview.
But all I'm doing,
don't try to play it.
But let me ask you then. Did my producer invite you on based on this article from Ebony.com?
Several other articles, and when I emailed and spoke with Kelly,
but we're trying to get to that.
Let me finish the statement. When I emailed and spoke with her, I was like, hey, we can speak about that article and other articles, and also today, the day of love. Like today is our anniversary, so we'd love to talk. And reflection of our marriage. And then so we've been on the phone for half an hour, 45 minutes, and it's all been about this article that was labeled The Angry Black Woman.
And you're making generalizations about black women.
That's not a generalization.
It's
not.
It is a generalization. No, you don't have any facts. You're basing it on a stereotype, and that's what I am. That's what I've been trying to tell you. And you're trying to do this passive aggressive. Oh, but all I'm doing is asking you questions. Listen,
I am.
We
that's
do
all
interviews
I'm doing.
For a living. We understand where you're going with this. We understand what you're trying to do.
But you're also overreacting.
I'm not overreacting, but if that's what you want to believe, fine. We can agree to disagree.
Let me take a quick break. We'll come back to straight to the phones right after this, folks. Okay, we're going to try this again. And my guests are right in that there are other articles. 5 Lessons I've Learned with My Spouse, New Year's Resolutions for Marriage. It's just that we have not been able to move forward because Star is angry at me already and we can't move forward.
You are hilarious. You know that? You should be a comedian.
Let's go to Eric out of Los Angeles. Eric, welcome to the show, sir.
Hi, Jesse. Hi to your guest. Very interesting discussion. You know, the one thing I think is interesting is your guest star is saying that she says she's got a short temper, she has a tendency to go off, and everything that she says, she's not the stereotypical angry black woman, but she's displaying that on radio. And I think the editor of that article must have had some insight because by titling the article the way he or she did, they hit the nail on the head. One other point that I noticed, too, is that she's trying to provoke her husband to anger by telling him that you insulted him and all this other kind of stuff, when you did no such thing.
I know, I haven't.
Well, actually, I'm not trying to provoke him, but that is an insulting thing. If you were a husband and someone told you that you weren't leading your wife, I think you'd be offended, number one.
Why are you speaking for your husband? Why are you speaking for your husband?
Wait, no.
He should be able to say that.
I have a question. Let's move on. I have a question.
No,
did
he
you,
should
did
be
you actually
you
read
can't,
the article?
Hey, calm down. Why
I'm
are
not
you
upset.
Speaking?
What do you say? Stop trying to.
Why are
I know
you
what
speaking
you're doing.
For your husband? If he felt that way, doesn't he have the know-how to say that for himself?
I have a question, though, for the person who
called
in.
You didn't answer that question.
I have a question for the person that called in, if he would be so kind as to answer my question, which is, did you actually read the article?
I did not, but I've heard the conversation.
Okay, so you cannot make assumptions based on not reading the article, and that is my point. Thank you.
Where do you guys live? Because it's common knowledge that black women, this is a serious issue with most black women, this anger thing. And denying the problem is not helping the situation.
Right.
Which so
where do you
maybe
live?
You
I mean,
can...
you work for Ebony. How do you not see this pervasive anger within black women? And you're supposed to be giving people counsel and advice.
We don't just know one type of person. You know, we're from New York originally. We're in Chicago now. And we're from a knowledge base that you can't just lump people into one type of person. There are many alternates to every kind of person. I haven't met every person in the world. She hasn't met every person.
You don't have the common sense to look around you and the people you interact with and notice that black women have this anger issue?
But my common sense, the sense that I've learned in my 36 years, tells me you cannot judge and label people in one way. And also, my common sense would say that the conversation you guys are having with us right now, you're speaking to us 30 minutes, 45 minutes, you've read one article.
Actually, this caller didn't read the article.
Out of all the years we've been around, so getting a small fraction of who we are or who you think that we are.
Haven't done your research because both of our track records speak very highly for each of us. And I just would like to implore your listeners to actually read some articles from us before you make judgments because you're not getting a fair idea of who we are as people.
Hold on. Is it possible that the reason you won't admit that most black women are angry because you are it too, and most of the time when we are involved in something, we can't see the reality of it?
No, I think, sir, what the thing is like let's speak on one way that the term angry black woman is offensive.
So,
but why with, though? If it's true.
No.
But excuse me. Are you a black man? Do you know that several negative stereotypes?
I am as black as the ace of spades.
So you should know that several negative stereotypes exist about black men. So for you to sit up here and keep rehashing this angry black woman stereotype, it's insulting. If you don't understand that, I don't know how.
But I'm not insulted
if
it's the truth. It doesn't seem like you want to face
your
the truth.
That's the thing. It's the truth for you. For us, it's not the truth. So by you making that statement, starting our conversation off that way, you started off by insulting us.
I want to start off with the headline of the article here.
Passive aggressive thing is not cute.
What do you mean passive aggressive?
Listen, no, because what you're
on the
doing,
part of your husband or me?
No, this is no what you're doing. Because again, that right there is passive aggressive. You're trying to kindly insult us, and like I said, you start the conversation off with an offensive statement.
Let's go back to that.
We clarified to you that we did not label the article as such. The point of the article that my wife wrote was to say that yes, she does have some points where she deals with anger. She deals with being a hothead, quote unquote. And that I have helped her to learn to deal with that. But then
in specific situations,
let me do this.
It's not like an everyday, all-day thing.
Let me go to the phones. Bobby, go to a guy out of Los Angeles. You're on the air, sir. Thanks for calling.
Oh, thank you, Jesse. You know, the reason why this couple, in my opinion, is astray and they really have no advice to give is because they've abandoned the Bible. And the Bible says to get rid of all malice, anger in Colossians. Read the book of Colossians. Get rid of, and it's just one example, get rid of all anger, malice, envy, strife. It sounds like all that is in you. And when you have that, really, you can't see. That's why you can't see other people are angry, other black women are angry. You can't see it because you are it. And you just happen to be speaking to the one counselor who can help you get over anger so that you're not a victim of it anymore. He's not to blame for your anger, really. It's been there, as your husband can attest.
Thank you for your comment. Do you have any other callers coming in?
God, I'm being punked. Oh, my God.
Thank you, Barbara. Go to God. I do appreciate that, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your wisdom.
I want to New Year's resolution. All right, let's get to that. Can we try that?
I'm sure.
All right, let's see. What are your New Year's resolution? Let's start with Star. What's your New Year resolution, sir, for your marriage?
You know what? I don't choose to share that information right now. It's on the. I wrote about it, so.
Why don't you want to share it? That's why you're here.
Because I wrote about it. It's there.
But Star, you're losing it. How about you, Anselm? What are your New Year's resolutions for your marriage?
Well, I'd like to be there to help my wife get through situations where we've been railroaded and put into, awkward situations. You know, as always, I'll continue to be her support system.
But this is definitely a test. Thank you.
I don't understand why you're blaming me for the way you guys are acting. All I'm doing is asking the questions.
Right.
And
your wife is having
a hissy fit from the questions.
No, because, sir, like I said before, you started this conversation off with insult.
Let me take one final break. When I come back, I'll let you give out your information. Amazing stuff. Back in a moment. I'm looking at Barack Obama holding a press conference, and it's making me sick. I don't have the volume up on the TV here in the studio, but I'm looking at this guy. I just know that he's lying. He's a liar. Every word out of his mouth is a lie. He's incapable of telling the truth, and we are stuck with this sucker for another 4 more years. Can you imagine that? He and Big Mama. Tomorrow, Behind the Headlines guy is going to be dealing with the shootings in Connecticut and other areas and prescription drugs. He believed that that's what's causing it and not the guns. Don't blame it on the guns. Let me go quickly back to my guest. Would you guys like to give out your website or information so folks can read your articles for themselves?
Sure. You can always follow us at theloversrock.com, which is thelovers, R-O-C-Q-E, .com.
Anselm, I want to first say to you that if you guys need counseling, because it sounds as though you're going to need it, you can call me. I do counseling in my office and outside by way of phone call.
I look forward to giving you a call.
But buddy, I have to warn you that if you don't help your wife, show your wife how to completely overcome anger, you're going to catch hell and your marriage won't last because you're not going to be able to handle it after a while.
Because you're such a prophet and you just know this stuff, right?
Yeah, I know that. I've been counseling for the last 25 years, married couples.
Oh, congratulations.
Those guys who have been able to help their wives forgive their mothers for recreating them, their wives in their image, because angry mothers recreate daughters in their image. You become like your mother because you hate her. You hate her for what she does. You're laughing because you know it's true?
No. Yes, you're absolutely right. Thank you.
And well, your husband is saying no, and you're saying yes. So, but I do want to recommend, Star, that you forgive your mother because she has recreated you in her image.
You are so condescending, sir.
And you're not yourself.
Well, you've insulted
to
her mother.
To each their own.
Insulted our mother, my mother-in-law. You know, this has been a great interview, and it's definitely a lesson learned.
You don't see your wife acting out.
But I see you acting out as well.
Do you see your wife acting out?
Sir, are you done?
Thank you guys for coming. I wish you well, and congratulations on your anniversary.
Thank you.
All right, now. Amazing. I'll be back tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in and calling in.
This has been the Jesse Lee Peterson Show, produced by Bond, Brotherhood Organization of a New Destiny. Views expressed by guests and callers on today's program may not necessarily represent the views of this station. For more information, call 1-800-411-BOND. That's 1-800-411-BOND. Or visit our website at bondinfo.org.